Hi, my name is Akash. I'm a Microsoft Certified Professional and I have been working with Microsoft Services since last 10 years. Today, I'll be showing you how to use Power Automate, which is a free tool in Office 365, and it's really good for saving time. It is so easy that almost anyone can use it to automate those really boring and repetitive tasks. So I'm here in Office 365. I'm going to go to the App Launcher in the upper left. And you are going to see something called Power Automate. Let's click on it. If you have never seen this before, it's going to be really exciting. So let's drill in. Now, what this lets me do is create simple workflows so I can automate things like sending email attachments to my OneDrive, get push notifications when I get some important emails, and lots of other things. You can see here, there are some top picks. And there are some popular services that we will show now to get started. For now, we are going to do a really simple one. I'm going to the left navigation and click templates. This lets you see all the different template types. There are some featured ones. There are some shared with me. In this, you will see all the flows that you share with other people in your organization. All other tabs you see are basically categorization of all flows, templates, depending upon what a flow does. At any point of time, if you think none of the existing templates meets your requirement, which usually happens when you deal with some complex requirements, you can create a flow from scratch. For this, click on Create on the left navigation. You will see something like this. You will find all the existing templates here as well, but additionally, you will see one more option to create flows from scratch. The idea of this tutorial is to keep it really simple for the beginners, so I'm not going to cover creating flows from scratch. We are going to start with one of the most popular ones, which is save Office 365 email attachments to your OneDrive. Let's search for O365 templates. Here we see the template with the title Save Office 365 Email Attachments to Specified OneDrive for Business. So let's click on it. The flow will connect to Office 365 Outlook and OneDrive. Click Continue at the bottom and let's see how it works. So this explains the flow and description. This is how a flow looks like in the beginning if you have used an existing template. On the top, we have the trigger point, which actually decides when should the flow executes. Rest anything you see on this page are nothing but just actions. In this flow, the trigger condition is on new email. So that means whenever my inbox will have a new email, this flow will execute. This template is doing a little more than just uploading an attachment to OneDrive. The flow is checking something before uploading the files in OneDrive. Let's expand the condition to see what it does. So this flow checks who is the sender of the email and then perform other actions depending upon if the condition is true or it is false. For this demo, let's say I want to store my boss's email in one folder and rest all in other folder. So I will put my boss email ID in here. In my demo tenant, actually, I'm the boss of myself, so I'll keep my demo account here. And that means if the email is coming from an account which contains the word demo, in my case, it will be my demo email ID, then it will go to this part of the flow, or else it will go to the other part of the flow. So in here, I'm gonna store my email ID to my root folder. And I want to create a folder with name boss emails. And in the else part of the condition, let's say I want to name the folder other emails. Our flow is now ready. To test the flow, we can click on test on the top right. And before testing, we can click on save and let it to get saved. Now we can click on test, select manual, and click Save and Test. Let's go to the Outlook and I'll send an email with an attachment and we'll see how it works. I'm going to compose an email, sending it to my demo account. We can put the subject as test. I'm going to attach an attachment from my local drive. I'll pick lunch invoice and I want to send this to my boss. And send. So the mail is in my inbox now. Let's go back and check what happens in my flow. It says your flow ran successfully. Now let's go to OneDrive and see if it automatically saved my attachment. So here I'm in my OneDrive. I see the folder is already created with the name boss emails. I see my attachment, which I used in my email. It's already here, modified a few seconds ago. That means the flow has just uploaded it. That's just one example. Let's go back to flows. Now let's go to the connectors. This page gives you a sense of all these different options you have: Outlook connectors, OneDrive, SharePoint, RSS feed, etc. For example, if you go to Microsoft Teams, there is an entire page dedicated to Teams plus Power Automate. Let's pick next example where we can use this connector. So let's go to templates, type Teams in the search box. We will pick one of the most common scenario where a user submits a request and an approver has to approve or reject the request. This template looks similar, so click on it. You can see that this template is using more connectors than the previous one. We'll click continue without any delay. Let's check what this template is doing. It first of all triggers when a file is added in SharePoint library. Then it is posting a message in Teams. We will have to select the team and channel where we want to see the messages. You have a drop down to select the team. So I have a team called demo. I'm going to select this. And then in this demo team, I am going to use general channel for my communication purpose. After this, it is starting an approval process using approval connector. In approval connector, you see there are different options. In approval type, we are going to keep as it is. That is first to respond. That means if you are going to send your approval to multiple people, it will accept the first one to respond. Title is title of your email, which you are going to receive from this connector. We are going to assign this to my demo account. So I'll type my demo account email ID. Rest all are quite self-explanatory. So we will quickly jump to another action. Now we have two parallel actions. On the right side, we are sending notifications to, let's say, maybe admin, if the approval process couldn't complete for some reason. I'm the admin of my tenant, so I'll put my email as an admin. On the left-hand side, in the condition action, we are basically checking the response from the approver. If the approver has approved your request, then it will post some message in Teams. If the approver has rejected your request, then we will post some other message to the Teams. Enough of the explanation about this template. Let's fill in some information. For this demo purpose, I'm going to select my demo site. I will select the library. So let's pick draft documents and all other informations we have already filled. We are going to select some team here. I have a demo team to select. Let's pick demo teams in both actions and channels general in both the actions. And I see our flow is ready. So we'll save it and test it. To test the flow, let's click on test. Select manually and save and test. Now we need to go to the library where we upload the document from my local drive. Let's pick launch invoice. The document is uploaded. Now let's go back to the flow and see what happens. The flow is still running. This is the view which says that the flow is executed up to two steps from the top and it is now waiting for the approval from the specific user. The second action is actually sending a message in the team. So let's go to the Teams and check the message. So this is the message which I received. And the great thing about approval connection we have used in our flow is that we can receive the notifications regarding approval in the team itself. So if you go to activity, we see demo sent you a request. if we go to the request, we can check the details of the request and we can put our comments and take a necessary action. Test approve. Now let's go back to the flow and see how does it proceeds after this step. So we see the approval is already done and we have accepted or approved the request. So once the request is approved, this action is supposed to send an email in the channel. So if we go back to the Teams and check the message, demo has approved lunch invoice with comments. We can quickly grab one more example, let's say for some social platform. For this, we need to go back to Power Automate, go to templates. This time we will search for YouTube. For our demo, let's pick this one, which says when a YouTube video is uploaded, send an email. Let's see what it does. The description of this template itself tells us something. It says that when a YouTube video is uploaded to a channel, it will send an email. Let's click continue. So this is how this template looks like. The trigger point for this flow is when a video is uploaded by a channel. That means whenever a video is uploaded by a specific channel, which is linked with my connection, then the corresponding actions will take place. So with my personal account, I have a few channels already subscribed. So I can pick one. Let's say best.net training. And then whenever this channel will upload a video, an email notification will go to demo account with following details. And let's say if I want to have more details like title of the video, let's grab it here. And if I want to have even more details, let's say summary also, I will pick this one as well. And I may also want to check out the date when the video was published. So I will check the date as well. And I will save this flow. And now this flow will execute whenever best.net training channel will post a new video. If you want to explore more, you can always go to templates and check out all the available templates. This is just basics. I'll do a future video where I get a little more complicated in some of the flows that we will create. You can also let me know in comments if you want me to present a specific demo in Power Automate. If you found this video useful, give it a like. And if you want to keep up with all the latest quick tips videos that I'll keep releasing, subscribe to my channel so that you get notified for all the new videos that I post.